Okay, next thing that we're going to do is we are going to get rid of the little nags that come up when we log into the system, and I'll show the example. Right here it says no valid subscription and other things that are on there. And basically what that is here there's updates, and then from here there's repositories that it actually uses. It's got the enterprise repository is enabled, but there's no active subscription. This is if you're going to actually purchase the product or want support, stuff like that. And this says the Ceph enterprise repository is enabled, but there is no active subscription as well for those two. So there is a little script that you can run. So you'd have to log into the system. You could either do it through console here on shell. But I've actually putty to it, which is basically the same thing. And then here you would actually put the script that you want to run. And this was produced by T-Tech, and it's a post PVE install script. And that will go through and actually add the proper repos. And then after that, it'll actually help remove that nagging little thing on there. So we're going to hit enter here. And it's just letting you know that it'll perform a post-installation routine. We're going to say yes to that. And it's saying the package manager will use the correct sources to update and install packages on your Proxmox. And it says, do you want the enterprise is only available to users who have purchased? Do we want to disable it? Yes. And PV no subscription project provides access to all open source components to enable PV no subscription. We're going to say yes. Ceph packages, if you're going to use Ceph, depends. I'm not going to use it, but it can't hurt to have the packages there. And then there's also a test repository with new features and updates. And we'll say yes to that as well. And then this will disable the nag message reminding you to purchase a subscription every time you log in. Say yes to that. Supporting software's development team is essential. Check the official website for support, and we are going to say okay. It's saying that if this is going to be a non-high availability, we are going to disable that because we're not making this one a high availability. And it's going through and installing those, and we'll say yes, we're going to update it now. This will take a little bit of time. I'll fast forward once this is finished. And now it is asking to reboot the Proxmox V now, and we're going to say yes to that. And it has now disconnected us because it is rebooting. We can see the system booting up now. And it is ready to be accessed from the web browser. So we'll go over here and refresh it. And then you'll see that the virtual environment number will change. It is now 8.2.4. And we are able to get updates for the Proxmox VE. And it shows our repositories now that are active. That's basically what this script did. It took this and basically made these non-active. And then here's the Ceph that we can see. And we are good to go on there. And there's our VM that we created. And we should be able to start that up. And go to the console. So our system is now virtual machines up with no issues, and our Proxmox has been updated to the latest and greatest, which is 8.2.4. And then as well as we go to the data center here, we can actually see our PVE, and then we can see what updates we have, and we say refresh. It's just checking. Should be all up to date since we did do that. It says task okay. And we can see there are no packages, so we are good to go. And the system is all up to date. And that's how you run the post-install scripts and have a up-to-date system. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed that. Please look at those scripts. You can go through and actually look at the source code as well. From that, that will be posted in the notes afterwards in the description. It's a really cool script that just does everything that you'd have to do kind of manually, but automates it. Great work done by them, and there's multiple other things you can do as well from that website. Thanks again for watching, and hope you have a great rest of the day.